kerfluffle there, but good to go now, it looks like. So we're going to see an IO first overall pick here from LGD Forever Young Gods. This was the go-to hero for Secret in their opening match yesterday. It has been snatched away from them.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds reserve time. Team Secret's turn to pick. Remaining.
Yeah, Axe the reply now from Team Secret, so they're going to change it up here. Yesterday we saw the 4 of Tidehunter quite a bit with that IO in the opening stage, but they will opt to do something a bit different early on. So perhaps a page out of the MVP playbook. I mean, you mentioned it, it was more fun on MVP for 4 of, he got to play more exciting heroes, but he gets his hands on the Chopmaster.
Radiant Team pick.
Bad Rider!
Team Secret's turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, and I guess it is worth mentioning, there's not 100% guarantee this is forever on the Axe. B has played it as a greedy jungler at times. I think much more likely it's forever in the offlane, but definitely still possible they could throw a curveball here. As for LGD, they grabbed the Batrider. No Oracle picked up yet. And they do have the IO to work with, so we frequently see these two paired with like a Morphling as a carry, or someone who can, you know, very easily follow up on the Batrider lassos. And speaking of the Morphling, quick ban by Secret.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Whoa, got a little bit louder there. Okay, yeah, so Bounty Hunter now getting banned out. We saw Secret running the IO Bounty in one game. So rough start for them that time around, but they had that one really good fight. I think it was like 4 track kills unanswered, and it completely turned the game and forced a deciding game 3 versus newbie. So I'm not going to be able to have that level of comeback mechanic built into this draft.
5 seconds remaining.
Secret looking for that 4th ban. They will remove the Viper. Hero that can dominate 1v1 matchups. I think that's probably the biggest thing to note about the hero. And I was just going to say, are they looking for the mid 1 Invoker? Because it goes really well with Axe. Can be difficult to lane against the Viper as that particular hero, but I'm not going to see anyway. So mid 1. I mean, he really was impressive on his Invoker in that one game yesterday, Gods. They were down like 20-25k, and it still felt like they at least had a chance, but didn't end up working out.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Timbersaw!
Team Secret's turn to pick. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, also, it gives someone that can fuel the push as well with the Witch Doctor heal. So, we have seen a few of drafts this tournament where teams felt like they were lacking on their ability to mow down towers. So far, LGD for Young definitely fitting that particular bill. So they really have no way to kill structures reliably. But haven't picked their IO partner yet. It could well be a Sven, a Tiny. Maybe not a Tiny against Juggernaut, but someone that can bring those building downs in short order.
10 seconds remaining.
Storm Spirit!
Radiant Team pick.
Sven stands ready.
Team Secrets turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I should have seen that one coming.
Radiant Team ban.
The sack!
Alright. But did you see this one coming, Gods? The support Leshrac being grabbed to round things out. Unless they're running like a super greedy jungle Batrider, but that seems rather unlikely. How much do you think Slax is paying them? You know this guy. This guy, he has way too much power. First, already on a top two TI roster, and now to add to it, he is literally dictating the meta with meme videos. I don't know that anything more catastrophic could be happening to my Dota 2 gods. That's all right. We'll just invite Slax to the next summit, and then he won't leave. And this slight problem we've been dealing with will be well behind us. then Bruno will come back from the dead, and everything will be all well in the universe again. For our sins. Yeah, all those photos of Bruno, yeah, that's not really Bruno, guys. That's just his animated corpse walking around. He already died for our sins. But all right, guys, let's get into it. We are going to see an early D ward here. Xiao 8 able to kill one off. I think we saw, what was it, 3 D wards in the Veech Gaming series. And again, LGD able to start things off on the right foot here. As, runes will be grabbed one early. On the bottom rune, Puppy will take it. So it's the supports this time around, getting their hands on that extra bit of gold early on. And it will be a bottle immediately coming out for the IO. Our goodness. They go in though, onto 4F. The double stun combination comes through. There will be a puppy heal here. Allow him to retreat safely, but level 1 Omni Knight. Not really a lane where he can be too aggressive. Doesn't have the Uv. Hasn't gotten the Aura yet. No boots picked up either, so just gonna look to rely on the axe here to slow down Monet. Meanwhile, bottom, there's a tear. So, yeah, like you said, two aggro lanes, gods. Do you favor either team as far as their lanes go? Yeah, moves in on the pile I die. That level 1 Blade Fury, very long cooldown, 42 seconds. So they won't really be able to punish this, though, with the boots and just auto-attack. MP gets in a bit of extra chip damage here there. Lanes are going to stabilize, and looks like in the mid, a Timbersault versus a Storm, and so far, mid 1, doing quite well, and frankly, Gautiste had a good showing in pretty much all of his 1v1s so far this tournament. Moving on to Puppy. He does have the repel available. He tries to juke around the trees. It's not going to happen. Shaoed finishing off with just an extra auto attack there. And meanwhile, there was also a dive in the bottom lane as the Witch Doctor goes in, kills off LPC on the aisle, but it's a bit too late. The first blood will go the way of Forever Young in the end. And looks like the lanes are going to stabilize here. The Witch Doctor of Pile I Die limping back towards the bottom lane now, as he also had to sacrifice himself for that one. LPC going to join Shaoed. So they are going to rotate both supports here all the way up to the top lane. 2-1 right now for LGD Forever Young, looking to make it 3-1. And they're going to walk right into Forev. This rotation, I believe, was not scouted fully, but they have a suspicion there might be some heading this way. LGD not going to chance the movement in the end. They'll back away, and this does leave your Batrider, level 4, on an island bottom lane, but he's already got the boots, the windlace, and it's not going to be an easy kill by any means. They'll try for it with the cast. The bullet comes through, and they get the crit. MP, can he finish him off? Blade Fury still coin now, but the Maledict damage, it might just be enough. He's got no HP regen, and the last Maledict should tick him down. And pop goes the Batrider. I think he lives there without the crit. It's only level 1 Maledict, does not really do that much damage. But in this case, it was barely enough. Well, he gets a free fountain trip, and he does get back to the lane. Or rather, Monet gets back to the lane before the creep wave arrives. So they don't really miss out on too much lane experience or farm, per se. We'll see that standard Sven build, leveling up the cleave early on. Been seeing the Dominator rush for pretty much every Sven. There were a few games at TI where players, you know, make the adjustment, go for an early armlet, into an Echo Saber or even Blink Dagger and just like to fight, but are you expecting players are going to do that much in this tournament, Gods, or do you think it's more back to the old ways and the greedier build? Oh, the Malik did connect, though, and the Blade Fury just barely in range. He doesn't have that bonus move speed from Warcry, but in comes the IO. It's not a fair fight here for Secret, and now they want to make a move on MP on the Juggernaut. Phase Boots cooling down, but will he be able to get away? It looks like the Lesh Stun may have missed there. It's a little choppy for me, but I'm going to try a quick reconnect here. Reconnects, did he die? Okay.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Like, he could have just walked away, basically, and he tried to swag on him.
Radiant's
bottom tower. Oh, on the back of that now, he's down in CS as well as LGD Forever Young gonna bring still three heroes to this bottom lane. But they are pressuring the Sven. It looks like they don't want to just give him pre-farm. Instead, the Batrider heads to top for LGD Forever Young. And with all the musical aids here, LGD getting that 1v1 kill in the mid lane, it looks like should have a decent time of it, all things considered, but still Secret keeping it pretty close. Are you favoring either team towards the tail end of the laning stage here? Well, we had belligerent Triceratops here, refused to move respectfully out of the way of that camp, so Secret failing on their first ancient stack, presumably going to be for Forev. I feel like that bug has been in the game for a while, it feels like. Or is it a bug? Or is it just to increase the salt levels of Dota players around the world? Dire's top tower is under attack. So, I mean, in my eyes, this is Ice Frog's revenge. As they move onto the top lane, Young for you, getting caught out. Good cast there by Pi. Will secure the kill, but can Super turn it? Mid one is pretty low when it comes to mana pool. Does already have the Infused Rain just picked up, so he's a bit more durable. Meanwhile, bottom lane, MP spinning, and making a move on Xiaowei. Does have the Omni Slash available. And if there weren't a TP, he may have gone for the kill. Xiaowei already level 5 here as the support Lesh. Doing quite well in that regard. Super will walk in, walks right into mid one, and the Maledict's already prepared. That's a level 2 Maledict, but I think Super may be a bit too tanky to bring down. They're gonna need fall damage, and in comes Xiaowei, looking to turn the tide to this particular engagement. Super, can he find Pi? No, Maledict finishes him off. Mid one, turning back for another. He wants Xiaowei as well. Can he finish him off? The lasso comes through. Another stun will end mid one. He balls to the right, and he gets the kill before dropping. Even the neutrals cooperating. Basically a three-hero gank. As Forev struts off, it looks to even steal the stack. Everything going Secret's way there, and now leading 5-3.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Sven finally now does have his Dominator, but notice Secret, I mean, they're good at playing their own economy game, but they are also good at keeping tabs on yours already. Just using everything in their disposal to scout this out, they will see there aren't any agents being stacked yet, but a Hellbear Smasher arrives now, right as that illusion expires. So Secret, at this point, should be expecting the Sven, with the Mask of Death previously revealed, to be looking to stack some Ancients. And we will see the tower going down mid, last hit to Xiaowei, who is maxing out the Edict, to your point, just very much picked up for the tower killing potential. But at the same time, MP will grab the tier 1 bottom. LGD, they are smoked here. The wave is hitting their tower, though. Dire scanning to see if the Ancients are being farmed. Or potentially about to be stacked. Not the case, and they back away. Only showing Super here in the bottom lane. But it seems Secret recognized something is up. A forward Radiant scan. Not going to reveal a hero. could be very big, potentially. Is already an early hood grab on Super. Not too common to see a hood first, but he will be tough to kill.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Really delays your Bloodstone a lot, though. Young Kryu moving in. Oh, Death Ward coming through. The heal to start things off. The Maledict follow-up and mid one there. Looking to secure it. One more auto attack will grab it. Already a killing spree for mid one. Despite giving up a solo kill earlier, he's back in business, baby. And now Monet comes in, looking to try for the punish. Mid one in the trees. He's out. We'll make it home safely, but they're wasting a lot of LGD Forever Young's time here. Really pulling them around and not too much of a trade. Just the creeps killing a tier one top, but nobody to get the last hit there.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Super off to the neutral stacks now, and you can see Puppy already intent on slowing down the economy game. Axe has picked up his Vanguard for Ev, though. Blink still to come, about 700 gold away. Do you see either team feeling any particular sense of urgency, Gods? Are they both just content to farm right now as we head towards the mid game?
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Still no Blink on the Batrider. Young for you has had a very rough game. 35 CS, the next closest core is at 70. And it feels like that is really hurting them. There's going to be a last initiation. He just came in from the high ground, but mid one, looking to turn around, falling forward. He gets off a good remnant on 2-3 heroes for him. Still kept alive by the Omni Knight, gets off the call, but Chao 8 looks to chase him down, courtesy of the Pulse Nova. One extra auto tech will secure the kill, and all the while, Super on the Timbersaw in the backline finds a secondary kill, bringing down the Witch Doctor. They're hunting for more. Mid one will make it out, but unable to secure a kill. A good initiation there from the bat. All things considered, they even get the tower deny, and he did it without a blink. Couple more auto attacks, it's gonna be oh so close. He makes it out, I think it was like 60-70 HP there as the fountain regen begins to kick in, but that was scary close. Although he makes it out. So still these blinks yet to come. Batrider is closing in on his. Looks like Secret gonna maybe try for a move anyway, mid. Regen rune spawning now towards the bottom side. It would be a tasty treat for mid one. And the ping comes out from Puppy. Looks like they do want to secure it for him, if possible. And they know this is relatively safe, as they do have a ward here off in the Radiant Jungle. So they see the IO. They're about to see Monet, I believe, just for a little second there. And they will find the Sentry Ward that's been planted to slow down their ancient stacks. But Sven not really that far ahead when it comes to CS gods, nor when it comes to net worth. He's only 10 up on a storm. Normally you'd expect him to be, even if he's even on CS, he's got a lot more ancients and he's really a lot farther ahead, but still relatively close here. They're gonna make their move. They find mid one. Secret just made them and moved this way, but they ended up backing off. They have the axe blink. They had a smoke on Puppy, but they didn't actually go. Mid winds up getting caught out and punished, but Ken Secret looks to turn and get some vengeance for their fallen comrade. They call Super and they look to follow this up. Good repel there to keep Forev alive, but Super very tanky with the hood being self-activated, and now Timber chaining back and further away. He may still drop here. A follow-up call. A couple more auto attacks. The pure damage essential to try and bring him down. At long last, they will slay the beast. And along with that, the IO of LPC also dying a bit earlier, but still a Timbersaw and an IO for a Storm Spirit. Not too shabby, all things considered.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, they do have a great lineup to initiate fights with the Sven Blink. That plus the Batrider, who at long last has his own relocate to follow these ganks, can be devastating, but as you mentioned, it is important to find the Omni quickly and focus him down, or he can be very problematic the longer the fights go. Still no Orchid yet for mid one. It's been a bit delayed, and Secret are looking like they may want to defend this bottom lane. Currently, Batrider and Timber aren't there, though. This is not your relocate duo who can come and help the team during the push, so if Secret get wise to this, they could potentially punish this maneuver. They are looking for the jump on mid, and 4M instant reactions makes it out. They even prompt the relocate. Secret might be able to punish if anyone from LGD ends up sticking around. Oh, they found him. They know where the IO is coming back to. Can they fight around? It's LPC bringing back Young for you, and they both get caught by the heal bomb. The Lesh is there to try to cover the retreat. It's already too late. LPC down. It could be Young for you next. And it is, he falls, the Lesh 2-3 have been slain, it's all up to Sven. Monet on the run, heading to the north, Juggernaut spinning the other way as they corral that Sven and look to focus him down the heal bomb. It just ignores all that plus armor, and now Super, the last man standing. What a disastrous move on the mid lane. The relocate came out late, and after the Axe had already made it back to safety, those quick reactions from 4EV completely catching LGD off guard. Super hanging out in the mid lane, and MP now building straight towards a Defusal Blade, it looks like. No Ghost Scepters just yet on LGD. Not really that common to rush the Defusal at this stage on Jug, especially when he's like your... Well, I guess he's not your hard one position, you do have a Storm, but normally we'll see it a bit later on. Or if you're up against something like an Omni Knight.
Break. Haste.
You can purge the war cry, right? I believe that you can. Not the God Strength, but and maybe the buff. I mean, that doesn't really help the Juggernaut, but perhaps for the team could come in handy. Not entirely sure about that. But here goes the smoke. LGD Forever Young. I don't think Secret saw it, although it did look like it was near this Observer Ward, so they may have some idea. They are backing on that. Perhaps they did up the vision. Radiant scan reveals heroes. It could be tempting to creep around this cliff. They're only showing Super in the mid lane, but he's so aggressively positioned that it feels like Secret should know something is up. And I mean, just look at their vision in general, guys. They are vastly superior in the vision game right now. Lasso is going to find Puppy, but in come LGD Forever Young to turn around. Monet's there for the backup, but they're locking down, controlling him to cast. Absolutely devastating with the Death Ward as well. They shred three again. They look for a super, chaining away for dear life, but Mid1 has a decent amount of mana here. He could potentially give chase, and with the Diffusal Blade, they can lock super down. They will be able to kill him off. They get in range for a ball lightning into a pole, and now no Purge just yet. He manages to chain out again, turning back. Super completely surrounded here by the entire enemy team and no help in sight. Xiaowei has abandoned ship. He is all the way up top, and it will be a mega kill for 4Ev. And well, I guess the only good news is Mid1 doesn't have Bloodstone because he went Orchid build, but no extra charges for him. But this is still pretty ugly, guys. Oh god.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Well, last time they tried to lasso Puppy, it ended poorly. So even though he was scared just now by Young for You, I'm not going to chance that move. Yeah, I mean, you go back to that first 10, 15 minutes, he was sitting, I think it was like 35 CS when every core in the game besides him was at 70. And sure, Bat doesn't need as much farm as a Sven or a Storm, but it's just been a snowball effect ever since then. Sitting 0-5-3, he's died a lot, he hasn't CS very well. And LGD just haven't prioritized giving the Batrider a decent position in the game. Young for You, oh, is able to blink out. Good reactions there for him. Missy on the call. Just barely, though. Still chasing like he's maybe considering a go. Could initiate with Mid1, but that's a bit too far to die for a Batrider. And they will let him go in the end. I definitely have some older fellas here between Super and Xiaowei. But that mix of the old and the new blood has been quite effective for other teams, so we'll have to see how it pans out for LGD. This roster still in its infancy, at least with regards to their overall composition. Not looking too good for them here in game number one. It's a best of three, guys. The losing team still gets to play in the playoffs. Not tomorrow, but the next day they will kick off, but they will be starting in a lower bracket. Oh, sorry, I'm getting my time zones mixed up. Yeah, it will be, the games tomorrow will be the first round of the playoffs, I believe. Yeah. Yeah, no days off, no days off. Constant Dota here. All ones will break. Some arena somewhere in China, Dota will happen. Oh, happy memories. Are you excited for the cruise ship? I mean, being there would be great, right? Because if the event goes to shit, you just go for a swim. I feel like the primary reason for some teams going is not going to be Dota. Well, when it comes to Dota 1, having a great time now. Bloodstone picked up, his first extra Bloodstone charge secured. His balls in, assassinating Io with the Orchid. It's a food Io, really. It has gone for the Yule Scepter, but still very difficult to run away from a Storm 1v1. Stupendous. What is LGD's way back into this game for you gods? Any particular item, particular objective they need to be focusing on if they're going to turn things around here? Monet, just trying to finish up his BKB here, and just now secures the money for the recipe. As I believe a Radiant scan comes out outside the pit, doesn't find anyone from the looks of things. Looks like it was a Radiant scan, and Seeker gonna walk back in. They do have a medallion, freshly picked up down Puppy, and they will look to secure this Aegis for mid one. So,
immortality is mine!
Bail me out, gods. I appreciate you. Yeah. Well, it's called bringing balance to the Force Gods. if he only made the sick plays, things would have the line quick. So it keeps it interesting for the Seeker fans. That's pretty sure. Yeah, this might be worse than the last time I was connected. But oh well. Well, Steve's out now from Secret. As they head back towards their jungle, doesn't seem like they're in any particular hurry here. A Lotus Orb coming out soon for Super. Other items being progressed on. The BKB has been done on Monet, and it looks like he wants to make something happen with it, but this would not be the time to jump. And he isn't going to end up going for it.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Mid one, just gonna farm some noodles here, but the real action comes in the top lane in the form of MP. Starting to hit buildings at the same time though, with the Leshrac max Diabolic Edict, I think Forever Younger not too shabby at trading buildings here, gods. And definitely the faster tower killing lineup overall. So I wonder if they consider maybe trading even further than that. Monet does start headed towards the bottom lane. If Secret persists with this push. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And they're not even Secret, very indecisive here, not even hitting buildings, so they are going to make their move now. Mid one, setting up, will there be follow-up? A beautiful call by Forev, completely stretch them apart, two down, make it three. Looks like Forev got at least one dunk off there at the end. It was a devastating maneuver, so devastating, in fact. The echoes of that storm blowing in persist long after the bodies have hit the floor.
Invisibility.
All bonds will break.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Fear
Well, mid one posting up here in the top lane. And meanwhile, in the mid lane, Super has gone in, but Korev is able to get onto him. Storm following this up, trying to focus down Xiaowei. He does go up into the air, courtesy of the Yule Scepter, but as he comes back down to Earth, the real pain begins. Up to 17 Bloodstone charge for the Storm, and Rising Omni Slash coming through. It's not quite enough to secure the kill. Very delayed animations as Monet starts to work on MP, but now he is isolated. Two allies have fallen. Witch Doctor, the only hero secured so far by Team LGD, and Monet will have to blink away. This leaves... Oh, Super. Very unfortunate predicament. Can he get the call and make it out in time? He will be able to. No blink available for a little longer there. So he will end up barely escaping.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, mid one is just going ham at this point. Strictly Young Pretty, who brings him down, now turns back for Xiaowei. Can they finish off the Disco Pony? Not gonna happen, but Monet now left to his own devices. He's so desperate, he wants to get his own Defusal Blade. Does get the good Storm Bolt. The follow-up comes through courtesy of the Lash Stun, but mid one is Aegis to work with, and then he's got 9 Bloodstone charges, so he will have lives of to stack up in this fight. Mid one, does he go for the base? No, he backs up and tries to isolate more critical targets. Monet, focused by the Storm, tries to dodge the Storm Bolt. Not gonna happen, very low to the Echo, and not quite finished off that Saber. Insufficient to get the kill, leave Super very much isolated. Focus, not quite finished off. Mid one goes back in on a sliver of HP, but the long range Timber Chain could be enough to kill him off here, even with that little bit of extra damage. Just give the Maledict, he survives, he gets the kill. Mid one playing on said, and now he has the help of Puppy at his side. The Repel there will protect him against Xiaowei. 4 down, about to be 5. The Batrider will respawn with a lasso, but I don't get mad at it. LPC is in chop range, but there is no mana for a chop. Still, a blink in, looking for the spin. The Blade Mail comes through as well. Can finish the job. The heal there too. LPC just barely able to shake his booty back to the well. Now Forev, the man who wants to retreat, but lasso already committed. 4 step at the ready. Is there follow-up? Storm right in once again. On Young for you. The heal bomb 2. Is it enough? Makes him go pop. LPC just can stand and watch, and he too will fall. A full wipeout as Tipsaw just now rejoining the fray with this one. He had the Bloodstone Suicide buyback coming into the game again. He will die back as well, and with that, LGD Forever Young looking a bit worn out after this game.